When it comes to finding the information that you're interested in Pi, most of our applications will support doing a search through our asset database called PyAF, or the Pi Asset Framework. Now, PyAF is searched and navigated using either this Pi System Explorer that you see right here. I launched this by choosing Start, All Programs, Pi System Explorer. And there it is right there. Yeah, that's how to launch it. It's either navigated that way or using some widgets that are kind of built into the application, like Process Book and Data Link, that will allow you to traverse through these same hierarchies. And this is a hierarchical structure. If it can be created as a hierarchical structure, I should say. And of course, in most cases, it is. So for example, if I'm just interested in the asset called a pump that happens to be in Houston, and it's at a chemical plant in Houston, I can do this. I can drill down through my enterprise, find the chemicals division, find Houston within there, find my, well, I can look for it by looking at an equipment list, and I can find my pumps that way. Or I would probably more likely go into production and look at it kind of where it is within the actual production itself. And maybe if I were an instrument technician, I would look under the equipment list. But as you can see, we have the capability here through this asset database to display it a couple of different ways. So here's my pump. Okay, so what's the point of navigating here? Well, generally, the point is to look at the attributes. The attributes are where we're going to be making reference to things like, well, for example, in this case, a Pi tag. That's a Pi tag. That's the name of the Pi tag. That's the name of the server we're connected to. And as you can see here, it's showing me what that current value is. And within our clients, you're going to be able to make use of this to find the attributes that you want and then display it in your clients. So I can expand this a little. Let's make this a little bit bigger. You can see these are the different things. These are the different things kind of hanging off of that pump. It's got a head pressure, temperature inlet, temperature outlet. So these are, you know, these are the things that are associated with that particular asset. So that's how you can find the information you're interested in. And incidentally, in addition to Pi tags, of course, we can also have other data references. We can have references to data that's sitting in a relational database or data that we're retrieving through some other data reference like a web service or a table that's built within the asset framework itself. Now, this is really an introduction into what is a much bigger topic. And by all means, go out and take a look at our AF computer-based training. If you're interested in more information about this, we go into much, much greater detail. But I'd like to just introduce our discussion of Pi tags by saying that's how you can find your tags. You know, these Pi tags are the kind of the fundamental that we use when we work within Pi as a system manager. So if I need to find, you know, those particular pump Pi tags, this is how you can do it through this traversing this hierarchy. Now I can also find it using a search. There's a nice option within here. Let me go ahead and open up the advanced search. There's a nice option here to do an advanced search in which we find, you know, specific nodes within our tree structure. Let me go ahead and go all the way to the top. And I'm going to specify that we search for the sub-elements as well. And I'm going to search for all those elements that have the word pump. So I'll go ahead and choose search. And as you can see, this has now gone through and just simply found those that have that pump. And now I can inspect this on my own. I double click here, it'll bring up that pump and I can take a look at the Pi tags associated with it. Now, I didn't mention this specifically, but the nomenclature that we use, I guess I mentioned this once, these are the actual elements, these pumps right here, pump 001, 002. Those are elements. Those are the name of the elements. These are attributes. The attributes are basically the things hanging off the element that point us, in most cases, to the real-time production data. And by the way, I just want to add, in case anybody's, again, looking at this and saying, wow, why go to all this trouble? Why not just create like a Rolodex, a laundry list of Pi tags? Actually, you'll see that. You can also search for the tags like a Rolodex, like a laundry list. using the regular tag search that we're going to see in a different video. But the point of putting together things in an asset, a database like this, is because when you have these two different pumps here, we know they're going to have similar process metrics. So for example, I know that each pump is going to have a head pressure, but also it's going to have an inlet and outlet temperature. And this is something I might not know if I'm simply doing searches based on names. I guess it would be a little bit more or a better example if we were to look at something a little more complicated. For example, let's look at a reactor. As you can see, this reactor has many, many attributes. And it's nice to have a single kind of one-stop shopping for you to first define what those attributes are, and then, you know, once you've defined those attributes in a template, then to ensure that all of the reactors have all of these process values associated with them. We've seen over the years what typically happens, you know, in 2003, one guy sets up reactor 101. In 2007, his successor sets up reactor 102. Unfortunately, his successor doesn't know the reactor 101 had all kinds of lab data associated with it, maybe relational database data, maybe calculations, maybe alarms. All those types of things can be kind of hung off of that element so that when, you know, the new guy comes in and says, well, it's time to build reactor 102, let's take a look at what's in 101. He knows just by drilling down through here all the different, you know, all that consequential process information that's associated with that particular asset.